Hello everyone, my name is Praveen Vaishnav. I am the head of training and recruitment center at Titanium Education of English Language. We receive many requests and suggestions from our viewers and students to make videos on group discussions. So we are very delighted to introduce a new series of videos on group discussions where students from different batches will participate and they will discuss the given topics. As we all know that GDs have become a very important part of the interview process. Most of the companies conduct group discussions to check the communication and skills of the candidates, right? So today I have a batch of 4 students here. First of all, on behalf of Titanium, I welcome all of you here.
Thank you, sir.
Right. So now, first of all, I would like you to introduce yourself. Then we will start. So we will start with you.
So my name is Ankit, and I am a PhD student, and I am so thankful to Titanium for giving me this wonderful opportunity, sir.
Hi everyone, my name is Chaitanya. I belong to Udaipur, and I would like to give thanks to Titanium team for giving me chance to speak in front of you.
Good morning, sir. Good morning to everyone. My name is Prerna, and I am pursuing MSc in Botany. I would like to say thanks to Titanium for giving this golden opportunity.
Good morning, sir, and good morning, guys. My name is Lokesh, and I'm preparing for government jobs. And first of all, I would like to say thank you for Titanium Group for having me here.
Okay. So today we have very interesting topic. So are you guys ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the topic is Indian culture versus Western culture. So everyone will get the chance to share your points. So we will start with you. Here we go.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Me and Chaitanya will favor in Indian culture. And in Indian culture, if we define culture by the way of life, then I must say that Indian culture has some qualities. As the one first and foremost quality of Indian culture is it preaching us the values like peace, the values like non-violence, harmony, and tolerance. In the contemporary world, they are much needed. We can see this. And in the past, we can see the self-centered idea of Western culture resulted into the 2 world wars. And right now, they are making chaos also. The second thing, the diversity. We believe in diversity. We appreciate diversity. The thousands of languages are present in India, and thousands of cuisines, thousands of dress codes. We believe in diversity, and as we know very well, that diversity is a spice of life. And the third thing is that Indian culture believe in interpersonal relationships, that we respect relationships, and we believe in joint family kind of situation. And we think we share our sorrow and happiness together, and we live like this. And this is the 3 things. I think this is the best thing about Indian culture.
Very well spoken, Ankit. Yes, Chetan, what you have to say?
As far as my view, first of all, what is the Indian culture? The culture which is followed by the Indian people is called Indian culture. And my first and foremost point is Indian people are more concerned about environment and their health. And for example, our ancestor knew that peepal tree is one of the very few trees which produce oxygen even at night. Because of its unique property, in order to save this tree, our ancestor related this tree to God and religion. And if we talk about the health, then India has earned very good name in the field of yoga and meditation in abroad. That's why our gurus are teaching to the Westerners to how to keep calm and relax and keep away from disease. And my second point is that in Indian tradition and scripture contain various sign and symbol. For example, the swastika. It is the symbol of Lord Ganesha, and all the arms of swastika have different meanings. And my third point is that in India, saying Atithi Devo Bhava means guest is equivalent to the God, and it is a Sanskrit word taken from Hindu scripture, and it shows guest has more importance in our Indian culture. That's it.
You both spoke very well, but now I want to define culture. What is culture? So culture is a characteristic and knowledge of people, the way of life defined by everything from language, attires, cuisine, music and arts. Every country has their own culture and tradition, Now we are discussing about Indian culture and Western culture. So according to me, both culture have their own importance. Indian culture tries to connect us with our tradition, and Western culture gives us a new perspective. I have seen lot of good things in Western culture, so I want to share with you. My first point is job and integrated part of life. So the people from West, they are really very open-minded, and they never think about other people, that what they will think. So they live their life according to their desire. My second point is politeness. The Western people are very polite in their everyday life. So for any fault, gratitude, excuse, they have three magical words: sorry, please, thank you. And my third point is no judgment. The people from West usually don't judge one's life on the basis of their perceptions, which may be influenced by their caste, sex, and races. They believe in equality, so they give equal chance to both gender. That's it.
You spoke well, guys. Today's topic is very interesting, which is Western culture versus Indian culture. As per my concern, Western culture is more important than Indian culture, because Western culture is more modern and advanced culture, right? And Western culture is followed in Western cities like USA, Canada, and European countries. Like, and in Western culture, people leave their homes at the age of 18 to become self-dependent. And second thing is they have given freedom to take their own decisions on their own, right? This is not the case in Indian culture. And last point is they actually more concerned about people's privacy. They give more to their privacies, because we know privacy actually helps to maintain individuality and autonomy of a person. So that's why I will say that Western culture is more important than Indian culture.
Okay, you spoke very well, guys. So I must appreciate that you shared your points in a very good manner. So if you have any questions, you can ask to anyone. So yes, the house is open for the questions. Yes. Who would like to ask first?
Sir, yes, I may ask. Sir, my first question is, sir said that they leave their houses very earlier. They believe that in early ages, a child should take decisions. Right. But in this case, they can be misguided by anyone others. In this case, they can be face a situation like depression. Okay, then they can be go into the consumption of alcohol, drugs. This can be situation, and they are doing this. So how what is your opinion on this?
Actually, we have you raise a nice question, Ankit. Actually, this is not the case for all 100% people, right? If there is a lot of so many cases we have, so people get success at the early ages.
Sorry to interrupt. Yeah. But I must say that this is the situation in most of the cases. The alcohol consumption of alcohol and drugs and so prevalent in Western countries. You know very well, sir.
Of course, I know. But what I am saying is that actually people get success at the early ages. Like Selena Gomez, Justin Bieber, they are the person that get success and fame at the early ages, at 15 and 16. Why? Because they have freedom to take decisions on their own. This is what I'm saying. And actually, in Western culture, parents allow their child to make mistakes and learn by their mistakes, right? And in Indian culture, parents spoon-feed their child. They don't allow their child to make mistakes. And as we know, that trial and error is the best way to learn and develop skills, right? That's why.
Exactly. Yes. Any other questions? Yes, please.
My question for Prerna, ma'am. And you spoke very well, ma'am. And in a Western culture, people have approach of materialistic nature, and they have been consuming more natural resources, and it won't be available for our next generation. So what's your opinion about this?
Yes, sir. You asked a really very good question. I will make you understand. And you said, yeah, because of our developing, because we are a developing stage. So if we want to become luxury life and we want to live in a comfortable life, so we have to become materialistic. So it's a need of our now in a days.
Okay, thank you.
Actually, you said that we live, India is a diversity, yeah. And we live in unity in diversity, right? And we have a lot of languages, so many languages in India we spoke, right? So my question is that, what is the use of these languages? Because if you go in other regions, there is other language, right? Yeah. So there will be a communication gap between peoples. So how will you justify that we have so many languages is good for us?
So language can be a big barrier between people to communicate with each other.
Yeah, I want to say so. If you go in another state, then you will face some problem in language. But there is it's a beauty of our Indian culture. We will get chance to learn new language and we can communicate with new peoples in different languages. Okay.
Sorry for interrupting, sir. Yeah. You said, we can get chance for learn new language. But if we will go only for a few days, so we have to learn new language for communicating them. What's your opinion in our condition?
For a few days, what is the option? You cannot learn a language for a few days. So that is a big problem now.
I want to come here that in this situation, we can use the alternative of English language and Hindi language, the common language that most of the people know this language. We can use this.
And thank you, sir. And I have another problem in Indian culture. Here, people follow same old method to achieve their goal. No one bother to change it. And we don't have any freedom to choose our career and life partner in our life. So it's good or bad?
Your question is very nice and very contemporary. But we have to see the fact that every culture has some lacunas and problems in their own and some qualities as well. So, and their earlier nascent stage of development, every culture have these prejudices, these problems like inequality towards women and gender discrimination and no liberty to decision making, all the situation they faced in their early nascent stage. The Western culture have got liberated earlier, so they started preaching these ideas very earlier. Unfortunately, we got liberated on 1947, and then onwards we started preaching these ideas of equality and the decision making. We believe in the liberty of child and all these things. And so far, in 70 years, I think we have passed a good, reasonable margin. And now the situation is changing, and we can see all over the India that the modern parents are believing in the ideas like equality and no discrimination and respect to decision makings and privacy as well. Thank you.
That was really very wonderful, guys. You put your 100% efforts. So I would like to conclude the topic today that every culture has its own benefits, its own qualities, and they at the same point of time, they also have some problems with their culture. But what we need to understand that we need to respect the culture of others, right? We have this freedom of following our culture, but at the same time, we need to respect the culture of other people, right?
We can take good things from
others. Yes, we can learn good things from others as well, right? So, that was really wonderful, guys. And believe me, guys, if you keep doing this kind of practice, you will surely get confidence and it will help you improve your GDA skills. I request all our viewers to subscribe our YouTube channel and please do not forget to press the bell icon to get the latest videos. That's all for now. Please share this video with your friends and relatives so that they can also improve. See you next time. Till then, keep learning and keep practicing.